Well, welcome to another big edition of Rawk Haul. Being in Canada, you gotta like Rush, gotta like the Vancouver Canucks, and you gotta hate friggin' snow. I don't know if you can see that big pile, but just in a parking lot, it snowed a lot more last night. I don't know if you can even see the top of the... But anyway, let's put you down here. Okay, we can whip through this quick, I guess. What's playing? Jet. It's funny, Dr. J, Jody Watson and I were talking about this band, and I finally bought it for cheaper than what that says. But, song you should all know. Ah, tambourine. They throw in the odd little tambourine or piano bit, but... Yeah, you all know that one. So I leave that on in the background. Couple of these are just kind of like $2 a piece type thing, compilations, and thought, what the heck. Never seen this one before. Amazing Blue Oyster Cult! There's a whole ton of songs on here. Look at the printing here. I'll let you figure it out if it's, you can even read it. But so I'm hoping they're kind of remastered. And yeah, Blue Oyster Cult's fantastic. How many songs? Well, whatever, lots. And at the same place, I found this. Anything after Jakey Lee, Ozzy, I don't care for, but it's a double album. I said, are you gonna be my girl? Kind of a goofy cover there, but song selection has, I don't know, Live with Randy Rhoads. It's a lot of the early stuff, Paranoid with Randy Rhoads. Well, here's the track listing's pretty good. Man, for $2, what the heck? And here's one commonplace. All right. Smarten up. Blonde girls with long hair. Bad combination. Well, I guess dark hair. Same deal, but anyway. Pretty common, but it's always good to... I wonder if there's any live stuff, like anything off of Fandango on here. Doesn't look like it. And then here's a comp of Judas Priest, but I would hope the... Hope this is remastered. This is a later type thing. 14 songs. Kind of cool packaging. Just kind of pops in that little deal, but for $2. This was $5, new, but I didn't have the CD, so what the heck. I almost cracked this open to play Bark at the Moon, but, and then more junk. This was like a $10, but really good hardcover. I don't know if it's good or not, but big hardcover book. Don't just stand there when you're playing live. You may as well be dead. But color photos and... Oh, this could be quite the book. I don't know what the heck is... Wow, they saved that inside for me. Wow. But anyway, for $10, 300 pages. Here's a band, this is $8. I don't own any of their stuff. Megadeth, I don't know, everyone in the VC loves these guys, but the only song I've ever liked by them was when they covered Paranoid by Sabbath, which they did a phenomenal version on, maybe Nativity in Black, maybe? I can't remember. And I already had one Rush book, Chuck Pinozzo, I think it is, the bass player. Oh boy, I'm going by memory, but had an autobiography, which was not really a tell-all, but it was interesting. But this one has direct interviews with Tommy Shaw. They had the manager for 7 years. He's involved. I guess other guys too. I haven't even looked at this yet, but this is a huge book. 364 pages right to the back. Dave Harris radio guy. So anyway, it should be interesting. It's only $3.99. Then we get shirt action. Seal the reveal. Oh boy, trusty knife. Just tell it's a shirt that I ordered, but don't know what one. Okay. Being in a Ramones tribute band, never hurts to have any Ramones shirts, so. Too bad he did pass away, but that's pretty cool. And another shirt that just totally burned me. I got a phone call saying your shirt's here and you owe $24.15 in brokerage fees. Well, what the heck is brokerage fees? $25 for a $20 shirt? It was open, security checked. I don't know, whatever. I guess they're making sure things are safe, but no idea. Says what the shirt's worth on the outside, 20 US, 30, which is 30 Canadian. Add in the 20, it's like a $55 shirt now. Boy, oh boy, is this thing packaged like from Indonesia. Hope they get amnesia about paying $55 for the shirt, but trusty knife. Come on. I always get a kick out of watching everybody else struggle with the just live TV here. Struggling away. Holy cow, and still another package. Okay. Maybe this was included in the price. 55 US. Well, I don't know about you, Canadian. But anyway, this shirt. This one. My wife questioned me about. She just basically said, how much is too much for a t-shirt? And I said, I don't know, $100. And so she kind of left it at that because she knew how much this was. This, I don't know if it's going to be as nice live as it is, was on the, mellow sucks. Having songs like, got a song like that. But why play a song like this on the same album? It's like having a hot fudge sundae with broccoli on top. Mellow music sucks! Unless it's Skinner doing Simple Man or something like a power ballad. But anyway, don't know if you can see this very well. The front of the sleeves, the two guys there, and the back of the sleeve shows the other two guys. But anyway, that's the front. The classic first album. Here's the back. This was the back what sold me. R.A.M.O.N.E.S. Ramones! Cloudy, stormy, milder, just saw Richie Ramone live. Last summer I saw Marky Ramone live and CJ Ramone live. But look at this. Just the intensity of Johnny Ramone's phenomenal. Boy, I'm gonna be wearing this to practice next time. See that? To me that shirt's worth the price. That's what I need, one more. This is gonna be an unsealed reveal instead of Rawk Haul. My wife bought me a book for Christmas, but I already had the book, so I took it back and then paid the little extra, well, 10 bucks more, whatever it was, for this. I've already got this album. Definitely, they should have kept the same cover as before, but it's the 40th anniversary edition of 2112. Oh, I don't know if you can read that. Paid top bloody dollar for this, but... Whoa, what the heck is falling out here? Oh, the booklet. How much time do we left? Let's put it in.
That team, he did a masterful job with that group.
Big game tonight. Canucks and Flames
was the best team there. They just had some bad luck and some shaky goaltending.
But Rush, would you please welcome from Toronto, Canada, Rush. Let's get to. There we go. But big booklet. Oh, lots of write up. Oh, the whole thing's a write up. No real pictures except for, I got to see them on that tour and the All the World's a Stage tour, if I recall right. See, this song picks up. Could be mellow and pretty, but the deal with this is you've got the regular album, then CD2's bonus tracks, so you've got a bunch of covers like Dave Grohl, Billy Talent, Stephen Wilson, Alice in Chains, Something for Nothing, Jacob Moon, and then 2112 Live at Massey Hall 1976, Something for Nothing, Live Massey Hall 76, Twilight Zone 77, 2112 radio ad. Anyway, DVD, double CD and DVD. The DVD has Live at the Capitol Theater 1976. So you've got Bastille Day, which is a 10 out of 10. Anthems, 10 out of 10. Lakeside Park, come and go. 2112, it's great. Fly by Night, I can handle it. In the Mood's great. So it's a half a dozen songs there. Then a bonus video is Overture, Dave Grohl, Taylor Hawkins and Nick Rescalenza or something. Then Passage to Bangkok, Behind the Scenes with Billy Talent. And 2112, 40 Years Closer. A Q&A, question and answer session with Alex Lifeson and Terry Brown, who produced Rush right from the start. I know he was on the first album, and I guess probably Fly By Night. Maybe Caress of Steel and 2112, I don't know. But so anyway, that's that. So, Lou Duva, veteran boxing trainer on Spartan training regime of heavyweight Andrew Galata. He's a guy who gets up at 6 o'clock in the morning, regardless of what time it is. Anyway, cheers, BC! Peppermint mocha! And then for lunch, mint. Oreo, or mint arrow. All right, bro. Thanks for watching. And after it, we're grabbing. Keep up the right, right, Claudie? Copyright by Cody.